Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by Justin Kenna. He's the CEO of GameSquare Esports. Justin, very good to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, Stephen. How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. So Justin, for those viewers not already familiar with GameSquare, tell us about the company and what it is that you do.
Yeah, absolutely. So GameSquare, our whole ethos is around connecting global brands with the gaming and esports community. So this huge fan base. I'm sure anybody who is familiar with the gaming and esports space understands that there's a huge amount of eyeballs within these communities. And we've built a vertically integrated platform that helps brands connect with these huge audiences.
So take us through your business model and how you do connect the brands with the audiences.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's a really interesting space, right? And I think for brands, can be a little challenging in terms of reaching audience in this space, given how fragmented the industry is. For example, Counter-Strike fans aren't necessarily Fortnite fans, and people are consuming content, in a lot of different ways. So we help devise and build strategies for brands to connect with fans. And we also have a media network that specifically targets audience and actually guarantees a certain level of engagement, which has really resonated well in terms of our value offering. But I think the easiest way to kind of think about GameSquare is three main buckets. Bucket number one being esports. So that's our professional gaming team, Complexity Gaming out of Frisco, Texas, formerly owned by Jerry Jones, the Dallas Cowboys. Jerry Jones and John Goff are our two sort of major investors. They own around 40% of GameSquare today. We have 10 professional teams in 9 different games. What's 10 in 9 is we also have a female and male Valorant team. We have around 70 creators, so gamers that are streaming, creating content and so forth, and actually launched the first ever athlete gaming division. So we represent 9 tier 1 athletes across the major sports, being NFL, NBA, UFC, Major League Baseball, etc. We've grown our audience within Complexity Gaming from roughly 10 million when acquiring it in June of last year to over 120 million in our aggregate following. That's kind of bucket number one. Bucket number two, which is actually our real secret sauce and really where we help monetize those eyeballs, is through our media and agency businesses. So we have Code Red, which is an influencer and consulting agency over in the UK. We have GCN in North America, which is a marketing and media agency. They have a media network, as I was alluding to before, that reaches 115 million gaming and esports fans every month. So they create large bespoke campaigns for brands and then guarantee a certain level of engagement by reaching specific audience. And then we have Cut and Sew, which is our marketing creative strategy house, also based out of North America. And our third bucket are our services, which we've actually built out in the last 12 months. We have a Web3 agency, a content studio based in LA, and a merchant consumer product business. And we've been lucky enough to attract over some really top tier talent. A lot of people who are familiar with the space would understand who FaZe Clan is. FaZe Clan are the largest brand by audience in the space. They actually went public earlier this year in a SPAC offering at a market cap of around $1 billion. We're actually able to bring across their ex-head of content to run our content studio and also their head of merchandise, who's running our merchant consumer product business. Two people with a real track record in speaking to youth culture.
You talked about the market being very fragmented, Justin. Are you taking advantage of that to make acquisitions and make it less fragmented? I know you've just announced a $3 million private placement, which was very well supported. Will that money be going towards helping to defragment the market?
Yeah, I think it's a really interesting one. I think we are traded on the CSE today. We have an OTC listing in the US. There's a real catalyst there for us to get a major uplisting in the US. The reality is we are a US-based business, but we have seen the ability to acquire some really interesting cash flow positive private companies like a Cut and Sew or a GCN that we've been able to bring in in a normalized market, make multiples on in the public market. There are a number of private companies out there within this space that have really nice business models that may not have access to capital or liquidity. And obviously we can offer that. We have a great shareholder base. As many people be aware of some of the frustrations in the market today, definitely have affected us in terms of valuation. But, with that comes opportunity. And I think we're seeing that. We have a lot of shareholders who believe in what we're doing. So we're really focused on, the fundamentals here, really growing out the business. And as the market turns, we think we're going to be really well placed to take advantage of that. And I think the fragmented piece you speak of, absolutely. The financing will be used to continue to grow and scale. I think we've proven out in a really short space of time that this model works. And while we do have competitors in within those kind of three buckets that I alluded to, we don't have a major competitor in terms of this vertically integrated platform. And the model we're building is unique. We're proving out that it works. We have the ability, once a brand enters the GameSquare ecosystem, to continue to upsell and keep margin in-house. And we've been able to upgrade revenue guidance twice this year, most recently by 20% up to 30 million off the back of 9 million in revenue last year. So really exponential revenue growth, proving out that the model works. And obviously we think we're going to be really well placed as the market starts to correct in terms of driving real shareholder value.
How fast is the esports market growing, Justin?
I mean, incredibly quickly. The numbers are crazy. I think around 26% of Gen Z now say that gaming is their number one form of entertainment, and 12% is browsing the internet. So this next generation of consumer, they live online. I think a third of the world's population plays games to some degree, right? Whether that's mobile gaming, video gaming, or whatnot. So those numbers are continuing to increase. We're also seeing, that market share kind of erode a little bit from traditional sports, and seeing a lot of really interesting plays from traditional sports trying to integrate gaming and esports strategies into their core product and core business. And that's a really interesting one for us also. We are the agency of record for the Dallas Cowboys, obviously the highest valued sporting organization in the world, and currently working on some really exciting projects to really create a blueprint, help them be a market leader in reaching this next generation of consumer. And that's also a strategy that we think that we can help roll out to a number of different traditional sporting and entertainment organizations.
So Justin, what are some of the catalysts your investors should be looking out for in the short to medium term?
Yeah, I think, as I said, I mean, we did an RTO in October of 2020. So we look at 2021 really as kind of year one of the business. As we kind of touched on, we did quite a bit of acquisition last year. This year has really been about organic growth, really about optimizing and proving out this model, which I think we've done really well. So continuing to see that growth in revenue, growth in margin, this path to profitability. And I think now growing and scaling out this model in other areas globally, which we're starting to look at. I think the other key one, I sort of touched on it before, is a major uplisting. As we touched on, we are OTC listed in the US. However, there are still some challenges in terms of accessibility to the stock. We are working on different strategies to get a major listing, uplisting in the US, which we think will help. We have obviously a lot of deep connections and relationships into the US, whether it's through our major shareholders with the Jones and Goffs, or our most recent announcement with our $3 million financing from a really large US strategic group. So I'd say continued revenue growth, growth into new markets, US uplisting.
Any particular market for that uplisting, Justin?
Yeah, in terms of uplisting, I mean, Nasdaq, New York Stock Exchange are the two obvious ones. As I said, we've been exploring ways to get there sooner rather than later. I know it's a real priority for us. In terms of kind of growth of the business, you know, throughout Europe makes a lot of sense for us. We have an influencer and consulting agency in the UK, our head of European operations, Jan Neumeister, is ex-City Football Group, has a great agency background. Recently brought in Lauren Baines, who's our head of European sales. So continuing to kind of grow and roll out our content, media, and agency capabilities in the UK and throughout Europe is our really obvious next step.
Justin, I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress, but thank you very much for the introduction today.
Absolutely, will do. Thanks, Stephen. Appreciate it.
Justin Kenna is CEO of GameSquare Esports. We'll be right back.